Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A recently released video clip provides stunning support for the Electric Universe interpretation of one of the most dramatic atmospheric phenomena on Earth, above clouds lightning. On October 15th, 2019, a pilot named Chris Holmes was flying about 35,000 feet above the Gulf of Mexico when he noticed multiple forms of powerful electrical discharge, called sprites and jets, erupting from a thunderhead. The still image seen here is a, quote, gigantic jet, a towering form of electrical discharge reaching all the way to the ionosphere, which is now known to sometimes occur above powerful thunderstorms. This exceedingly rare video clip reveals the top of the cloud from which the jet emerged, affording a groundbreaking opportunity for insights into the phenomenon. Investigator Oscar Vanderveld of the Lightning Research Group split the video footage into individual frames and described the observed sequence for the website spaceweather.com. He states, first, relatively cool blue filaments spring up. These are streamers akin to St. Elmo's fire. Next, after the jet reaches its maximum height, another feature crawls more slowly out of the cloud top, a white-hot lightning leader. The Space Weather article notes why this is a surprise for conventional meteorology. For years, some researchers thought that gigantic jets could reach such extreme heights only if their streamers got a boost from the lightning leader. Holmes's video shows just the opposite. The gigantic jet reaches the ionosphere before the lightning leader even leaves the cloud. Oscar Vanderveld concludes on the images. This suggests that there may be a much more powerful electric configuration inside the thunderstorm than was previously thought, perhaps as much as 200 million volts. To understand the significance of these insights for the Electric Universe predictions and interpretations of extreme above clouds electrical discharge, let us first consider a surprising historical background on the question of so-called lightning in Earth's upper atmosphere. Although numerous eyewitness accounts of the phenomena, including the testimony of airline pilots, trace back many decades, it was only in the late 1980s that the first photographic evidence was obtained of an above-clouds discharge called a sprite. However, as early as the 1920s, the Scottish physicist C.T.R. Wilson predicted the existence of brief flashes of light above large thunderstorms. A fundamental question that must be asked is, do scientists today really understand lightning? As those who follow this series are aware, what we observe in nature, as well as recent scientific discoveries, demonstrate that the answer is no. These points are illustrated when we consider the research into lightning by Professor Edgar Baring of the University of Houston. In 2001, when Baring flew a high-altitude balloon above a thunderstorm, he made the unexpected discovery that when lightning strikes occur both above and below the clouds, the electrical charge was already present and did not take time to build up between lightning strikes. This contradicts the standard notion that lightning is the generator of the clear air electric field, measured at about 100 volts per meter between the Earth and a clear sky. In standard theory, lightning's generation of power requires water droplets to separate charge in clouds, a process that remains mysterious and unverified. The Electric Universe theory, however, sees lightning and the cloud activity as a, quote, load that is being driven by electric currents from the sun. It is the electrical circuitry between the sun and the Earth that drives all lightning. And scientific research provides support for the role of the electric sun-Earth connection in lightning. As we reported previously, in 2014, scientists in the UK discovered a dramatic increase in lightning strikes for up to 40 days after a major solar storm. Simply put, the reason the aforementioned observation of the gigantic jet is, quote, surprising, is that the electrical charge that created the jet was already sitting at the cloud tops, which is not surprising at all from the Electric Universe perspective. As physicist Wal Thornhill has proposed, the highest clouds essentially act like one plate of a capacitor, which responds to the buildup of charge in the ionosphere above, which is where the above clouds lightning terminates. Thornhill explains, the gigantic jets and other forms of above clouds electrical discharge are electrical breakdown channels in the Earth's, quote, leaky atmospheric capacitor. The discharge channel of Birkeland filaments narrows and forms the bright jets as it reaches into the more dense lower atmosphere. On our planet, we benefit from having clouds to distribute lightning more widely than on other planets. For instance, Venus does not have water clouds, yet the early Russian Venera space probes discovered evidence for Venusian lightning, which is both vastly more frequent and powerful than earthly lightning. And on the planet Mars, where the rarefied atmosphere is about 0.5% as dense as Earth's. The clearest evidence for powerful, lightning-like discharges is in its towering dust tornadoes and global dust storms, which are electrically driven phenomena. And just as earthly lightning appears to increase in direct response to increased solar activity, we now have evidence that dramatic dust-raising events on Mars may be linked to outbursts from the sun. For several years, scientists have puzzled over dramatic dust plumes which occasionally erupt up to hundreds of kilometers above the surface of Mars. As we reported in 2016, investigators studying data from the Mars Express spacecraft found that immediately before the observation of a dramatic plume, the planet was hit by a powerful CME from the sun. As one investigator noted, "It's very surprising that was affecting Mars right before the plume was first observed." So it seems that an understanding of high-energy electrical discharge phenomena on planets, including Earth, will demand a new understanding of the electrical nature of the sun and of all stars. It was well over a century ago that physicist Christian Birkeland proposed that the earthly aurorae were produced by electric currents from the sun. Astronomers almost universally rejected the idea for many decades, until it was finally confirmed by discovery. Likewise, all forms of lightning, as well as the most powerful gigantic jets in our upper atmosphere, testify to the electrical circuitry that connects all celestial bodies in our solar system, and indeed pervades the entire universe.